to my class. 今天是我们的第十四节课，我们将要讲解 Unit 2 Part 3的两篇词汇课以及一篇对话课。Are you ready? 首先进入第一篇 vocabulary, emergency vehicles. Emergency, 紧急事件、突发事件。Vehicles, 交通工具、车辆、机动车。注意啊，中间的 H 一般是不发出来的。Vehicle, 所以连在一起 emergency vehicles 就是紧急情况下所使用的交通工具。一般呢，这类交通工具我们在现实生活中见的不会特别多，不过呢，在影视剧里估计都看的不少。大家能想到哪些呢？我猜大家第一个想到的应该是救护车吧。我们这篇词汇课里第一个提到的也是它，救护车 ambulance。在第十二课的时候我们已经见过了。If someone has a heart attack, call for an ambulance right away. 如果有人犯了心脏病，赶紧叫救护车。那在本课中，懂你英语是这样描述救护车的。Ambulances are used to transport injured or sick people to a hospital. Are used, 这里使用了一个被动语态。Ambulances are used, 用来干嘛呢？ To transport injured or sick people to a hospital. Transport, 运输。在这里呢，做动词，注意重音放在后面 transport 它做名词的时候重音则放在前面 transport injured 形容词表示受伤的救护车被用来运输受伤的或生病的人们去医院 What is used to transport people to a hospital? Ambulances are used to transport injured or sick people to a hospital. 那为什么人们会使用救护车呢？我想不仅是因为救护车反应迅速，还因为车上有专业的医护人员，他们能够为伤者或病人提供专业的治疗。An ambulance has trained medical personnel who can treat injured or sick people. Trained.形容词表示培训过的、被训练的、训练有素的。Medical 也是形容词，意思是医疗的。Personnel 名词指员工、职员，有指受雇于某一组织、公司或者是军事机构的职员。注意发音哦 ，personnel 重音在最后。所以 trained medical personnel 意思就是受过专门训练的医疗人员。那也就是说专业的医疗人员了。An ambulance has trained medical personnel. 这些专业的医疗人员能够给予伤者或病人专业的治疗。They can treat injured or sick people. Treat 意思是治疗、医疗。后面可以跟人 treat someone, 治疗某人。Treat patients, 治疗病人。后面也可以跟疾病 treat cancer,Cancer 是癌症，治疗癌症 treat cancer. Treat malaria 是疟疾的意思，治疗疟疾 treat malaria. An ambulance has trained medical personnel who can treat injured or sick people. 后面的 who can treat injured or sick people 整句话都用来修饰前面的名词 personnel， 也就是说 who can treat injured or sick people 是一个定语从句。An ambulance has trained medical personnel who can treat injured or sick people. 好，说完了救护车，我们来看下一个运输工具 ,wheelchair. A wheelchair is for people who can't walk. 从这张图我们能够看出来，接下来我们要讲的就是轮椅。这个单词的构成也很有意思啊。Wheel 是轮子、车轮的意思。Chair 是椅子。那合在一起变成 wheelchair 就表示轮椅了。A wheelchair is for people who can't walk. Who can't walk 整句话用来修饰前面的 people 也是一个定语从句。轮椅是给那些无法行走的人们使用的。A wheelchair is for people who can't walk. 接着懂你英语中还继续描述了轮椅的构成以及用法。Wheelchairs have four wheels and are often pushed by people from behind. 轮椅有四个轮子 ，wheelchairs have four wheels， 且一般由后面的人推着往前走 ，and are often pushed by people from behind。push 意思是推，推动。轮椅总不能自己推着自己走吧？所以呢，这里使用了一个被动语态 ，are pushed， 被推，被谁推呢 ？By people from behind， 被人从后面推。Wheelchairs are often pushed by people from behind， 轮椅一般由人从后面推。另外啊，这里顺便提一下 ，often 这个词的发音，在懂你英语中大家听到的是 often， 可能跟大家平时说的 often 不太一样，但是呢，两种发音都是 OK 的。我们继续来看下一个 emergency vehicle。Fire engines are used to fight fires. Fire engine 不是火引擎啊，是救火车、消防车。Fire engines are used， 这里依旧使用了被动语态。消防车被用来做什么呢 ？To fight fires. Fight 与什么什么做斗争、努力击败，所以 fight fires 就是灭火。我们还可以用 fight 来描述与其他事物做斗争，比如 fight colds and flu， 抵抗伤风和感冒 ；fight crime，crime 是犯罪的意思，所以 fight crime 就是打击犯罪。Fire engines are used to fight fires. Fire engines are used to fight fires. 那既然说到了消防车，就必须得再提一下我们敬爱的消防人员。Firefighters like this one often rescue people from burning buildings. Firefighters, fire 表示火 ，fighter 是战士、斗士的意思，合在一起 firefighter 与火战斗的战士，那也就是说消防人员啦。另外，消防队员也可以说 fireman。Rescue。营救、救援 ，rescue somebody from somewhere， 意思是把某人从某地营救出来。比如文中的 rescue people from burning buildings，burning 燃烧的 ，burning buildings 燃烧的大楼。像图中这个消防人员经常把人从燃烧的大楼中营救出来。Firefighters like this one often rescue people from burning buildings。既然说到消防车和消防队员，在这里给大家补充一个冷知识，在法国有一种 party 叫做 the fireman's ball。ball 在这里不是球的意思，而是指舞会。这个舞会的主办方呢是法国的消防局，而这个舞会啊，竟然是为了庆祝法国的国庆而举办的。想不到吧？法国人庆祝国庆的方式竟然是在消防站开 party。那大家如果有兴趣，可以上法国旅游局的官网查一查。能够查到巴黎每个区里举办 party 的消防站地点哦。要是以后去巴黎旅游，正好碰上国庆，可千万不要错过这个狂欢的机会。咱们言归正传，回到懂你英语，看看下一个出场的 emergency vehicle。Tow trucks are used to tow cars。哎，先不说别的，大家应该又发现被动语态了吧 ？Are used 被使用，是什么被使用了？是 tow trucks， tow 是拖拉的意思，注意不要和数字 two 弄混了啊，一个是 tow， 一个是 two， truck 货车、卡车，所以 tow trucks 就是拖车、救险车的意思。Tow trucks are used to tow cars， 这里出现了两个 tow， 第一个 tow 是名词，它做定语修饰 truck， 后面的 tow 是动词，它也是拖拉的意思。Tow cars， 拖车，把车拖走。This tow truck is towing a car to a repair shop. Repair shop， 修理厂，咱们前面也是见过的啊。Repair shops are where people go to fix things which are broken or not working right. Repair shops are where people go to fix things which are broken or not working right.那最后一种运输工具有点酷炫啊！通过图片我们知道主角是直升机。Helicopters are used to rescue people from dangerous places. Helicopter 直升机 ，helicopter 一共四个音节 ，helicopter are used 被使用，用来干嘛呢？To rescue people from dangerous places. Rescue somebody from somewhere 这个短语又出现了。Rescue people from dangerous places 将人们从危险的地方救出来。Helicopters are used to rescue people from dangerous places. 在现实生活中啊，有很多紧急情况都需要使用到直升机，尤其是在灾难救援的情况下，因为使用直升机可以将伤者迅速从交通不便的地点送往医院。那懂你英语就给了这么一个具体的例子。This helicopter is lifting someone from a sinking boat. Lift 做动词时表示举起、抬起、吊起。Lift someone or something 就是抬起某人或某物。This helicopter is lifting someone. 把人从哪里抬起来呢？From a sinking boat. Boat, 船。什么样的船？ A sinking boat. Sinking 的意思是正在下沉的。This helicopter is lifting someone from a sinking boat. 这个直升机正把一个人从下沉的船上吊起来。This helicopter is lifting someone from a sinking boat. 好，那么以上就是第一篇词汇课的所有内容。我们学习了五种不同的 emergency vehicles， 它们分别是 ambulance、wheelchair、fire engine、tow truck， 还有 helicopter。其中呢，课文里有不少的描述都使用了被动语态，因为这些 vehicles 要被人使用，所以呢，往往要用被动语态来描述它们的作用。Now let's move on to the next part: weather and activities， 天气以及一些和天气相关的活动。首先来看第一句， This tree is bending over because of the strong wind. Bend over, 弯曲、弯折。Because of 我们也很熟悉了，后面加名词成分表示由于什么、因为什么。So, why is the tree bending over? This tree is bending over because of the strong wind. 这棵树正被狂风吹得弯折。句子使用了现在进行时表示说话时正在发生的动作。It's going to be windy for the next few days. 还记得 be going to 这个结构吗？ Be going to 是一般将来时的常用结构，表示将来会怎么怎么样或将来会做某事。It's going to be windy for the next few days. 意思就是未来几天风会很大。It's going to be windy for the next few days.狂风过后，我们来看一个晴朗的天气。It's a very clear night, so they can look up and see many stars. Clear, 晴朗的、纯净的、清澈的。比如 clear water, 清澈的水。Clear sky, 晴朗的天空。那么 clear night 就是晴朗的夜空了。It's a very clear night, 夜空非常晴朗。So they can look up and see many stars.所以他们能够抬头看到许多的星星。Look up 就是抬头看，往上看。Star 星星。说到这里啊，不禁想起 Coldplay 的那首 Yellow， 其中第一句歌词就是 Look at the stars, look how they shine for you。看那天上的星星，看他们如何为你闪耀，是不是很有意境呢？好，我们回到课文。那既然能看到星星，云朵一定不会太多。咱们课文里也说了 ，There isn't a single cloud in the sky. Cloud 云朵 ，single 单一的，仅有一个的。There isn't a single cloud in the sky. 天空中一朵云都没有。Single 它也有单身的、未婚的意思。但是想要表达自己是单身狗，千万不要说 I'm a single dog。直接说 I am single 就可以了。There isn't a single cloud in the sky. 天空中没有一朵云。说完了晴空，咱们再来唠一唠炎热的夏天和寒冷的冬天。先来说说冬天。It's very cold today, so they are wearing very warm clothes. 今天非常冷。It's very cold today, So they are wearing very warm clothes. Warm 在形容衣物时表示保暖的、暖和的。It's very cold today. 今天非常冷。So they are wearing very warm clothes. 所以他们穿着非常保暖的衣服。Wearing very warm 好像有点难念啊。注意区分 W、Wear、Warm 和 V、Very。They are wearing warm clothes because it's very cold today. They are wearing warm clothes because it's very cold today. Without warm clothes, they would freeze to death. Without, 没有，无。Without warm clothes, 没有保暖的衣服。They would freeze to death. Freeze, 冰冻，结冰。The water freezes, 水结冰了。The pipe freezes, pipe, 水管，水管冻住了。北方的朋友应该对这个事儿不陌生啊，一到了冬天，露天的水管就特别容易冻起来。那如果说 freeze to death 意思就是冻死。Without warm clothes, they would freeze to death. 没有保暖的衣物，他们可能会冻死的。情态动词 would 指想象中会发生的情形。What would happen if they weren't wearing warm clothes? 在这句话中 ,would 是 will 的过去式。Were 是 be 动词的过去式，有没有感觉看起来怪怪的？那为什么整句话要这样说呢？划重点了，这里其实是使用了虚拟语气。什么叫做虚拟语气呢？很简单，使用虚拟语气是为了表示假想。那这里是属于表示与现在事实相反的假想情况。假想他们没有穿厚衣服，但事实上他们确实穿着厚衣服。你看，都与现实相反了，那肯定得使用虚拟语气了。那虚拟语气该如何使用呢？也很简单，表示与现在事实相反的假想，只需要将谓语动词变成相应的过去式就好了。比如这里的 will 变成 would， are 变成 were。注意 ，be 动词不管是 am、is 还是 are， 在虚拟语气中一般都要变成 were 的形式。也就是说，不管主语是第几人称 ，be 动词都用 were。来看看下面这两个例子 ：If I had the money。I would buy a big house. 现实的情况是我不够钱买一套大房子，所以呢，这里使用了虚拟语气 had 和 would， 分别是 have 和 will 的过去式。再看一句 ，If I were you, I wouldn't do it. 如果我是你的话，我不会这么做。不过我不是你，所以这里使用了虚拟语气 ，be 动词用的是 were。那么冬天就先说到这里，咱们来看看懂你英语是怎么描述夏天的。It's nice to eat ice cream on a hot day. It's nice to do something, 就是说做某事令人感到惬意、开心。It's nice to stay at home when it's raining outside. 下雨天窝在家里真是再舒服不过了。It's nice to read for a while before going to bed. 睡觉之前读读书也是不错的。So, what is nice to eat on a hot day? 大热天吃什么最开心呢？It's nice to eat ice cream on a hot day. 大夏天的来根冰淇淋简直不要太爽。这不啊，途中的妈妈就给女儿买了一个冰淇淋。This mother is buying ice cream for her daughter. Buy something for somebody, 为某人买某物。Her boyfriend is buying a dress for her. 她男朋友在给她买裙子。I'm going to buy a big house for my parents in the future. 未来我要给父母买一套大房子。This mother is buying ice cream for her daughter. 这个妈妈在给女儿买冰淇淋。This mother is buying ice cream for her daughter. 在这篇词汇课的最后，我们来看一个特殊的活动。This old man has to wear glasses to read. Glasses, 眼镜。这个老人家需要戴眼镜来看东西。This old man has to wear glasses to read. He doesn't have good close-up vision, so he needs reading glasses. Vision, 视觉、视力，这个词也有幻觉、幻象的意思。在漫威漫画中的那位超级英雄幻视，英文就是 vision. Close-up vision, 近距离视力。He doesn't have good close-up vision, 他的近距离视力不好。也就是说，这位老人家有老花眼 ，so he needs reading glasses. Reading glasses 就是老花镜，所以他需要用到老花镜。Without reading glasses, he can't see clearly enough to read. Clearly, 清楚的、清晰的。See clearly enough, 看得足够清晰。Without reading glasses, he can't see clearly enough to read. 没有了老花镜，这位老人家就看不清楚东西了。OK，第二篇词汇课到这里就结束了。我们接触到了几种不同的天气情况，以及一些和天气相关的活动，并且复习了用 be going to 的结构表未来，还学习了虚拟语气。Now let's move on to the last part。最后，让我们进入到今天的对话课，checking up on Ada。Ada 的前同事一男一女聊起了 Ada。首先是男士向女士发起对话，How is Ada's new job in Beijing？提问某人或某事进展如何、表现如何，疑问词用 how，比如 How is your business？你的生意做得如何呀？还有我们常说的 How are you？你最近过得怎样？How is Ada's new job in Beijing？Ada 在北京的新工作怎么样啊？女士回答说：It seems to be going well。Seem 表示似乎、仿佛，seem to be 加形容词。或 seem 直接加形容词，表示某人或某物看起来怎么样。比如 ,You seem younger than my friend. 或者说 ,You seem to be younger than my friend. 你好像比我朋友年纪小。Seem 后面也可以加 to be doing. 比如 ,They seem to be having a good time. 他们看起来玩得很开心。所以 ,It seems to be going well. 意思就是 ,Ada 的新工作似乎一切顺利。那这位女士是怎么知道 Ada 的情况的呢？课文里说 ,I talked with her last night. 哦，原来是因为她昨晚跟 Ada 聊过。这时候男士对 Ada 的薪资突然特别感兴趣，就直接问说 ,How much is she getting paid? Get 在这里代替 be 动词与后面的 paid 构成被动语态。Get paid, 被付工资，也就是得到报酬的意思。The bottle got broken.瓶子被摔坏了。回到工资的话题上，提问工资有多少，用 how much。How much is she getting paid? 她现在薪资是多少呀？诶，大家知道吗？在西方文化中啊，婚姻状况、感情状况、薪资等等，这些话题都属于个人隐私的范畴，所以不要随意八卦哦。How much is she getting paid? 对话中的女士是怎么回答的呢？她说 ,I'm not sure.我也不确定。She said she's earning more, but I don't know how much she's getting. Earn, 挣取、赚取。She said she's earning more. 她说她比以前挣得更多了。But I don't know, 但我不知道。不知道什么呢？How much she's getting. 不知道她具体赚多少。How much she's getting, 整句话作为 don't know 的宾语，是一个宾语从句。So how much is Ada being paid?She's earning more, but we don't know how much she's being paid. 既然女士对这个问题不清楚，男士就继续提问其他的方面了。Where is she living? 她现在住在哪里呢？Has she found a flat? 她租到房子了吗？Flat 是公寓的意思。另外，这里出现了一个现在完成时的疑问句。Has she found a flat? 她的陈述语序应该是She has found a flat. 我们来复习一下现在完成时的结构。它由 have 或者是 has 加上过去分词构成。比如 ,I have finished my homework. 我把作业做完了。Have you watched this movie before? 你以前看过这部电影吗 ?Has she found a flat? 面对租房子的提问，女士回答说 ,No, not yet. 不，没有呢。She's living with a friend.Until she can find one of her own. Of one's own 表示某人自己的。I want to have a car of my own. 我想拥有一辆属于自己的车。That's the house of his own. 那是属于他自己的房子。She's living with a friend. Until she can find one of her own. Ada 正和朋友一起住，直到她找到自己的房子。Until she can find one of her own.这个 one 就指代 a flat。那么如果要提问住多久，用 how long。How long will Ada be living with her friend? Ada 将要和朋友住在一起住多久呢？ She's living with a friend until she can find one of her own. 女士还继续说 Flats are more expensive there and the quality isn't good. Flats are more expensive there. 那里的房子更贵 And the quality isn't good. Quality, 质量它是一个不可数名词。房子质量还不好。哎，看来在北京找到合适的房子真是不容易。男士听了以后又继续问道 Did she say anything else? 除此之外 Ada 还说了啥？这不问不要紧啊，一问就问出了一个大槽点。女士说 Her biggest complaint is the air quality. Complaint, 名词，意思是抱怨、牢骚、不满。要表示大大的不满，形容词用 big. Her biggest complaint, 她最大的不满 is the air quality, 就是空气质量。What is Ada's biggest complaint? Her biggest complaint is the air quality. She hates the pollution. 她特别讨厌那里的污染。Cars are one cause of the pollution. 而汽车是导致污染的原因之一。On some days, the pollution is so bad that she is afraid to breathe. On some days, 有些天。So that 表示太怎么怎么样以至于。On some days, the pollution is so bad that she's afraid to breathe. Breathe, 呼吸。有的时候啊，污染太严重了，以至于 Ada 都不敢呼吸了。男士听了以后啊，连连表示同情。Yeah, I wouldn't want to live there. Would want to do 和 would like to do 都表示想要做某事。这里使用了否定的形式。Wouldn't want to do. I wouldn't want to live there.我可不想在那儿生活。不过话虽这么说，梦想总是要有的。女士就转述道 She's hoping it will get better. Get better, 变得更好。It will get better, 整句话作为 hope 的宾语，是一个宾语从句。She's hoping it will get better. 男士接过话头说 I'm sure it will, but it'll take time, especially with all the cars. I'm sure it will get better.我相信污染问题会变好的 But it'll take time 只是需要时间 Especially 是尤其特别的意思 Especially with all the cars 尤其因为那里有那么多的车 With 在这里是因为作为什么什么的结果的意思污染的话题告一段落女士还主动提起了 Ada 的情感状况 She also said she's still looking for a new boyfriend Look for 寻找Ada 说她仍在找新的男友 Still, 仍然也就是说 Ada 之前就一直在找了 Besides a flat, what else is Ada looking for? 除了找房子 Ada 还在找什么呢 She's looking for a new boyfriend 男士听了以后啊，感觉这不是什么难事 That shouldn't be difficult 情态动词 should 在这里表示一种可能性意思是将会That shouldn't be difficult. 找男票这事儿不会很难。为什么呢 ?She's nice and she's good looking. 她人很好而且呢长得也很好看。Good looking 就是好看的漂亮的。下次描述某人很好看啊除了 beautiful 和 handsome, 我们可以试着用 good looking. 夸完了前同事男士还不忘追问 ,Has she met anyone? 这里再次出现了现在完成时 ,has met.Met 是动词 meet 的过去分词。Has she met anyone? 她有遇到任何人吗？也就是说，她有潜在的对象了吗？女士替 Ada 否认了这个事儿。No, I don't think so. 不，我想没有。She's looking for someone on the internet. 她现在在网上找对象呢。听了这话，男士对网恋还蛮乐观的。他说 ,Maybe she'll be lucky. Lucky, 幸运的，走运的。还记得小时候如果在草地上摘到四叶草会被认为有好运降临吗？四叶草也被看作是一种幸运草，它的英文名是 four-leaf clover。现在大家想想自己的幸运数字是多少，然后呢就可以用下面这个句式表达出来。Something is my lucky number。用中国人特别喜欢的数字八举个例子，我们可以说 eight is my lucky number。还有啊如果身边的人运气特别好，比如说中了奖，或者是恰巧遇见 idol 啊，你就可以对他说 "Lucky you"， 你真走运，相当于口语中的“行啊你啊，哎呦不错啊你”。听到男士对 Ada 这么有信心，女士也有点心动了。Maybe she will. I think I'm going to try that too. 她可能真的有戏哦。我想我也准备试试呢。这里又出现了 be going to 表将来了。I think I'm going to try that too. 男士听了非常惊讶。Really? 女士就很无奈地说。What other choice do I have? Choice 选择抉择。What other choice do I have? 我还有其他的选择吗？其实意思就是 I don't have other choice. 我没有其他的选择了。为什么女士会这么绝望呢？她解释道：“It's so difficult to meet someone new. It's so difficult to do something. 做某事很难。Someone new.” 我们在第六课的时候讲过，如果形容词碰到了不定代词，需要把它放到不定代词的后面去。比如这里的 someone new，类似的还有 something interesting，一些有趣的事儿；anything spicy，任何辣的东西。It's so difficult to meet someone new，想要认识新的朋友很难。It's so difficult to meet someone new。而让女士结交新朋友很难的一大原因是她太忙了。I never have any time。这句话如果说成 I don't have any time 也是 OK 的，但这里用了频率副词 never，表示自己永远都没有时间。I never have any time。我真的太忙了。男士话表示他俩算是同病相怜。Me too。I'm always working。我也是哎，我永远都在工作。Always 也是一个频率副词，表示总是、老是。Maybe I'll try online dating too。Online dating，网上约会，也就是刚才说到的网恋。Date 有日期、日子的意思，在这里表示约会。约会也是要约个日子的嘛。不仅如此，男士对网上约会 online dating 充满了期待。If I'm lucky, I may meet someone new, like Steve's girlfriend。情态动词 may 在这里表示一种可能性。If I'm lucky, I may meet someone new。如果我幸运的话。我可能会认识新人呢，like Steve's girlfriend，像 Steve 的女朋友一样。一提到 Steve 的女朋友，这里出现了一个神转折。女士说：“Oh come on, you're joking, right？” 这里的 “come on” 意思是“得了吧，算了吧，别逗了”，有种不满的情绪在里面。比如说：“Oh come on, I don't want to go there。”算了吧，我不要去那儿。“Oh come on, I don't want to do it again。”得了吧，我不想再做一次了。Joke。开玩笑，joking 是它的进行式。You're joking, right？你在开玩笑呢吧？这句话在生活中也经常可以用到，尤其是当别人说了一些特别不可思议的事情的时候。那在这里，女士听到男士想找 Steve 女朋友那样的对象，感到很惊讶。You're joking, right？I hope you can find someone better than her。我希望你能找到比她更好的人。You can find someone better than her。整句话作为 hope 的宾语，是一个宾语从句。I hope you can find someone better than her。看来女士对 Steve 的女朋友评价不是很高啊。不过呢，男士倒是还好，他说 Steve seems happy enough。Seem 这个词又出现了，Steve seems happy enough。Steve 看起来足够开心，也就是说 Steve 还挺开心，挺幸福的。不过女士对这个说法也不买账。Yes, but he's blinded by love. You know that。Blind 可以做形容词，表示盲目的。比如人们常说 "Love is blind"，爱情是盲目的。Blind 也可以做动词，表示蒙蔽，使什么没有辨别力。Be blinded 被动语态，表示被蒙蔽。What is blinding Steve? He is blinded by love。他被爱蒙蔽了。下次如果你身边有人坠入爱河，陷入热恋，就可以开玩笑说 "You are blinded by love"，你被爱情冲昏了头啊！吐槽完了 Steve 还不够，女士还继续怼了一波她的女朋友。I'm sure it won't last for long. Last 持续、延续，last for long 持续很久。我确信他们的感情不会持久。As soon as she gets bored, she'll find someone else. As soon as 表示一什么什么就，比如 As soon as I find her, I will let you know. 一旦我找到她了，就会告诉你。As soon as she gets bored. Bored 感到无聊的，感到厌烦的。 As soon as she gets bored, 一旦她感到厌烦了 she'll find someone else, 她就会找别人去了。听到女士噼里啪啦说了这么一堆，男士就让步了。You may be right, 你可能是对的。Let's wait and see. Wait and see, 意思是等等看，走着瞧。生活中遇到一些一时半会儿还看不到结果的事情，就能用上这句 Let's wait and see, 咱们走着瞧，咱们再观望一下。那聊了这么久，两个人都聊饿了，男士就提议说 Hey, what about dinner? 去吃饭吧。女士赶紧附和道 Sure, it's getting late. 好呀，天色不早了。接着还开了个玩笑 And maybe I'll be the woman of your dreams. Of one's dreams, 理想的，梦想的。比如说，这是我梦想中的生活。This is the life of my dreams. 再来，假如你遇到了生命中的另一半，你可以说 She is the woman of my dreams, 或者 He is the man of my dreams. And maybe I'll be the woman of your dreams. 也许我就是你的梦中情人哦。当然了，女士也就是这么一说。Is she serious about being the woman of his dreams? 女士对于成为男士的梦中情人这事儿是认真的吗 ？Well, she's just joking, but it may still be true. 她其实只是开个玩笑啦。不过谁知道呢？也许两人就看对眼了。男士对这个调侃是这么回应的 ：Well, let's take one night at a time. Take one night at a time. 慢慢来，一件一件事儿来。前面俩人不是在约饭吗？这突然说到梦中情人的话题，男方就表示 ：Well, let's take one night at a time. 咱们慢慢来，先把晚饭吃了呗。接着男士又提议 ：Let's have some Indian food, okay? 咱们来点印度菜吧。女士感觉印度菜非常对她的胃口，马上就同意了。Okay, tandoori chicken for me, and I'm hungry. Tandoori chicken, 糖肚里烤鸡。Tandoori 其实是一种烹饪的方式，鸡肉在用香料和酸奶腌制好之后呢，会被放入一个叫 tandoor 的一个泥窖里面烧烤，以此制成的烤鸡就叫做 tandoori chicken 了。虽然有点重口，但其实挺美味的，而且很下饭。有机会的话呢，大家可以尝试一下。Okay, this is the end of today's lesson. 今天的课到这里就要结束了。我们来回顾一下今天都学了哪些知识吧。在第一篇词汇课中，我们学习了五种不同的 emergency vehicles, 并且复习了被动语态。在第二篇词汇课里，我们接触到了几种不同的天气情况以及一些和天气相关的活动，还学习了虚拟语气。最后，在 checking up on Ada 的对话课中呢，我们复习了宾语从句。那我们下节课再见，拜。